Hi and welcome to part 2 of my video playlist about the best methods to convert carboxylic esters into ketones. This video is about the use of ionic enolates as nucleophiles, that is, of lithium, sodium and related enolates of ketones, esters and other CH acidic compounds. The products are always ketones with an electron withdrawing substituent, and thus strong carbon acids. Like in the addition of polar organometallics to carboxylic esters, activation of the ester by the cationic metal is critical for the success of these reactions. Here you can see the mechanism of the acylation of a ketone enolate by an ester. Elimination of the metal alkoxide from the initially formed methylated hemiacetal yields a 1,3-diketone, which will be immediately deprotonated by the alkoxide. The released alcohol may protonate the starting enolate, and an excess of enolate can therefore be helpful to drive these condensations to completion. Because 1,3-diketones are rather acidic, their enolates are weak nucleophiles only, and will not usually react with the starting ester. These enolates are also poor electrophiles, and only rarely are tertiary alcohols formed as byproducts, even if a large excess of nucleophile was used. Ionic enolates may act both as nucleophile or as base. Due to their pKa values, methylated nitriles, amides, sulfoxides or carboxylates can in principle convert enolizable carboxylic esters into their enolates. In aprotic solvents and at low temperature, though, the deprotonation of CH acidic compounds is often much slower than the addition of a nucleophile to a carbonyl group. It is therefore possible to add, say, methylated amides to enolizable esters and obtain high yields of ketones. In this example, a lithiated imine was acylated at carbon with ethyl acetate. The resulting enamine was more resistant to hydrolysis than the starting imine, but can still be converted into a ketone by acid-mediated hydrolysis. Methylated imines are more nucleophilic and basic than the corresponding ketone or aldehyde enolates, and are often used as their synthetic equivalents. One potential problem of the use of ketone enolates is their self-condensation. This did, however, not occur in this optimized example, where a methyl ester was condensed with just one equivalent of acetone by treatment with sodium terts butoxide. With unsymmetrical ketones, the number of potential byproducts increases even further. In this example, 2-octanone was lithiated with LDA and then condensed with one equivalent of ethyl chloroacetate, which may also act as alkylating reagent. Still, despite the many potential side reactions, a substantial yield of diketone resulted. The enolates obtained by single deprotonation of 1,3-diketones are not nucleophilic enough to react with simple methyl esters. The dianions, however, are, as shown here. In this case, the dianion was generated by treatment of the starting diketone with an excess of sodium hydride. And because the electrophile was a non-enolizable benzoate, enolate formation and acylation could be conducted in one step. Strongly basic alkoxides can sometimes be prepared from alkali hydroxides and high boiling alcohols by azeotropic removal of water, as in this example. Here, the potassium salt of diphenylmethanol was generated this way and then used for the condensation of acetophenone with methyl stearate. A high yield of mixed diketone was obtained without substantial self-condensation of acetophenone or the ester. Methylated esters are inherently unstable and readily undergo Claisen condensation or alkoxide elimination. In the classical Claisen condensation, alkoxides are used as bases, which are usually not basic enough to convert all the starting ester into an enolate. Still, even pure enolate salts tend to dimerize in solution. The lithium enolate of terts butyl acetate has been isolated and seems to be quite stable at room temperature as a dry solid, as shown here. In solution, though, this enolate quickly undergoes Claisen condensation, probably by intermediate formation of ketene. Lithiated ethyl acetate is still more reactive and reacts with itself already at minus 78 degrees Celsius. Magnesium enolates seem to be slightly more stable than alkali enolates, but not much. In this example, the magnesium enolate of terzbutyl acetate was generated with isopropyl magnesium chloride and then added to octanone. The cross-condensation of two different esters sometimes gives acceptable results, in particular if one of the two esters has no alpha hydrogen atoms. In this example, ethyl acetate was condensed with an alpha-beta unsaturated ester, and a high yield of keto ester resulted, though the conversion was only low. A magnesium amide was used as base. In this example, the much weaker base sodium methoxide was used to condense ethyl nicotinate with ethyl acetate. Because pyridine is an electron-deficient heteroarene, ethyl nicotinate is more electrophilic than ethyl acetate, what might be one reason for the high yield of this reaction. The initially formed keto ester was hydrolyzed and decarboxylated by refluxing in aqueous hydrochloric acid. Oxalates are also highly electron-deficient esters and well-suited for crossed Claisen condensations. In this example, an aliphatic ethyl ester was lithiated with LDA and then acylated in high yield with a diethyl oxalate. The resulting alpha keto esters are suitable starting materials for the preparation of pyrazoles and other heterocycles, but may also be decarbonylated to malonates by heating to about 130 degrees Celsius. Formates are another type of electrophilic ester suitable for mixed Claisen condensations. Neither alkyl formates nor the resulting alpha formyl esters are particularly stable. Formates slowly decompose to carbon monoxide upon treatment with bases, and enolizable alpha formyl esters tend to oligomerize. Anyway, as shown here, these compounds are stable enough during Claisen condensations, and the products are valuable synthetic intermediates. Alternatively, mixed Claisen condensations can also succeed if one of the two esters is particularly unreactive, as in this example. Here, terzbutyl acetate was lithiated with LDA and then condensed at low temperature with an enolizable ethyl ester. Despite the structural complexity of the electrophile, a high yield of ketone resulted, together with a small amount of tertiary alcohol. If a given ester contains base-sensitive functional groups, one alternative is Claisen condensation of a titanium enolate. These can be generated from titanium tetrachloride without the use of strong bases, as shown here. These reactions usually only work well in non-coordinating solvents, such as dichloromethane. Even aluminum enolates sometimes undergo Claisen condensation. In this example, methyl adipate underwent Dieckmann condensation in the presence of an excess of triethylamine and aluminum chloride. Amides are still less acidic than esters, and strong bases are usually required to generate amide enolates. In this example, which is part of a new synthesis of racemic nicotine, NMP was condensed with methyl nicotinate with the aid of potassium terzbutoxide. A small amount of potassium nicotinate was formed as byproduct, either from traces of water or by nucleophilic demethylation of the ester. In this example, N-vinylpyrrolidone was condensed with ethyl propionate. The base was sodium hydride. Pyrrolidones are more acidic than non-cyclic amides, and their enolates apparently more reactive than ester enolates. Otherwise, this reaction would have yielded mainly the Claisen condensation product of the propionate. Here, NMP was lithiated stoichiometrically with LDA and then condensed with a methyl dihydroxybenzoate. A large excess of enolate was required to deprotonate the acidic hydroxyl groups. In addition to a low yield of ketone, substantial amounts of a tertiary alcohol were obtained. Also, DMA can be lithiated stoichiometrically and condensed with esters, as in this example. Because of the high electrophilicity of the ester, the reaction proceeded already at low temperature and was complete in only 15 minutes. Nitriles are slightly more acidic than simple amides and can also be condensed with esters. Reaction of methyl phenyl acetate with an excess of acetonitrile and sodium hydride, for instance, gave a high yield of cyanoketone. Despite the excess of nucleophile, no tertiary alcohol was formed. The dimer of acetonide trial probably also was formed, but remained in the aqueous phase during workup. Even cinnamates can undergo this reaction, as shown here. The anion of acetonitrile is sterically undemanding and very reactive, but no Michael addition to the ester or the product occurred. With the bulky ester of this example, though, the yield of cyanoketone was only 48%. One potential side reaction here was addition of the acetonitrile anion to the cyano group of the ester, but this did not occur to a large extent. A highly reactive cyano-chloroacetaldehyde was the product of this condensation. Because such products quickly oligomerize, the yield was not determined accurately. Carboxylic acids with alpha hydrogen can be deprotonated twice, and the resulting dianions are powerful nucleophiles. In this example, bocalanine methyl ester was converted into a chloromethyl ketone by treatment with an excess of the dianion of chloroacetic acid. The intermediate beta-ketocarboxylic acid decarboxylated spontaneously during workup. Thus, the dianion of chloroacetic acid played here the role of a chloromethyl anion. Chloromethyl ketones are valuable enzyme inhibitors and synthetic intermediates. These are usually prepared by treating diazo ketones with hydrogen chloride, but preparation of the required diazo ketones is tedious and involves diazo methane or similarly dangerous synthetic equivalents thereof that cannot be handled safely on a large scale. Carboxylated dianions can also be used to prepare alpha ketoesters from oxalates, as shown here. Unlike in the previous example, here a large excess of electrophile was used, but the yield of ketoester was only fair. Dianions are also strong bases, and one potential side reaction here was the formation of ethylene by elimination. Also sulfoxides and sulfones can be methylated stoichiometrically by strong bases and then condensed with carboxylic esters. In this example, methylbromopropionate was converted into a ketone by treatment with an excess of lithiated sulfoxide. Let's now have a look at some further potential side reactions. I already showed you some examples of the formation of tertiary alcohols as byproducts, but with ionic enolates as nucleophiles, this side reaction is much less critical than with polar organometallics. If the starting ester is enolizable and acidic, it may be deprotonated by the nucleophile and can even undergo Claisen condensation. These competing processes may be suppressed by lowering the concentration and reaction temperature and by avoiding amines, alkoxides, and other additives which could facilitate the migration of protons. Some highly electrophilic ketones, such as trihalomethyl ketones, 1,2 diketones, or alpha ketoesters, tend to form surprisingly stable hydrates or hemiacetals. These may require an additional treatment with some dehydrating agent to yield the target ketone. Some benzyl, allyl, or methyl esters may also alkylate a given nucleophile instead of acylating it. Particularly reactive are electron-rich benzyl esters. 4-hydroxybenzyl esters, as in this example, are exceedingly strong benzylating reagents because of intermediate quinone-methide formation, and thus not really representative, but also less reactive benzyl or allyl esters may alkylate nucleophiles. This side reaction becomes particularly prominent in the presence of catalytic amounts of late transition metals. This is an example of intramolecular alkylation of a ketone enolate by an ester. A substantial yield of cyclopropyl ketone resulted by C-alkylation with a secondary benzoate. Such results are difficult to predict, and a number of other products could also have been formed. Benzoylation at carbon would have proceeded through a 5-membered hemiacetal, and alkylation of the enolate at oxygen would have yielded a dihydrofurane. The formation of 5-membered heterocycles is extremely fast, but cyclopropane formation can be even faster, as shown here. Michael addition is a further potential side reaction that is difficult to predict correctly. The most reactive Michael acceptors are electron-deficient alkenes with a terminal methylene group, such as acrylates or metacrylates, while crotonates, as in this example, or cinnamates, undergo Michael additions more slowly. Anyway, as this example shows, also crotonates can react with carbon nucleophiles at the C-C double bond, even when no transition metals are present. On this and the next slide, there are some more examples for further inspiration. You can also find these references in the description of this video. The next presentation is about the conversion of carboxylic esters into ketones under acidic reaction conditions. These are mainly Friedel-Crafts type acylations of electron-rich arenes, but a number of other carbon nucleophiles can also be acylated by esters in the presence of acids. So don't miss it!